Cub, you want to take number 10, deals with conversion?
As you discuss conversion with peer persons and the people in the workplace, it's very clear that people believe they are Christians, but when digging deeper, most become defensive and do not have the words. And what biblical basis do we have, if any, to suggest spiritually dead persons could become
spiritually
alive Christians without knowing the time, place, that they're or a born-again experience? Or should we even go down that road with the people? If they, my first answer is, if they become defensive, you probably should not go down that road with that people. Because, you know, usually in a conversation with a friend or stranger, I would ask the question, where are you spiritually? And if they come up with any of these answers, I'm a good person, I go to church, or my granddaddy was a minister, you know, then you know they don't have a clue who Jesus is. There are accounts in Scripture. Peter, we don't know exactly when Peter, you know, came to Christ. Paul, we know exactly when he came to Christ. And Dett and I have talked a lot about this. We may miss some. Kevin is a friend of mine. Kevin, I've gotten to know each other the last couple of months. When I asked Kevin, where are you spiritually? Kevin, you know, he immediately said, I came to Christ during a Christmas conference in Atlanta this past December. We didn't need to go. I knew exactly where he was. And the rest of our conversation was about the Lord. I think the worst thing you can do, and boy, I might get thrown out of the church for this. I think what people get to see the most is when you go to the fruits of the Spirit, love, peace, patience, it makes people get comfortable like, oh, I'm a patient person, and I love people, and I have peace sometimes. I must be a Christian. I would take them straight to 2 Corinthians 5:17. Therefore, if you are in Christ, you are a new creation. Everything is changed about your life, and everything is not changed about your life and your heart. You're not born again.
My short addition to that is, dealing with conversions, if a person is offended by you asking, that person is not a Christian. And I would say that 100% of the time.
Yeah. Good perspective.
Toby? I'm going to say one thing, because the question, I think, is saying, is it possible to be saved and not know the time and the place? Now, I'm gonna jump out here, and I'm gonna say it is possible. And as I read Romans, Romans 10:9-10, it says, "If you confess with your mouth Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised Him from the dead, you will be saved. For it's with your heart that you believe and are justified, and it's with your mouth that you confess and are saved." And I'll tell you my experience. I was someone who believed with their head. That Jesus was king. I intellectually believe that, and I was lost as could be. And when your heart, the way I define the heart, and through study that there's the simplest ways to talk about it is your intellect. It is your mind, but it's also your emotions and passions, and it's your will. And so when you believe with your heart, it's got to change you. It shows up in your actions. You're a new creation. Your will causes you to do things. Okay. And so I was lost as could be, started working for a man at age 25. He'd started discipling me every day at work, and I started reading the Bible. And somewhere, it went from a head thing to a heart thing. I can't tell you the day or the time, but I'm here to tell you I know Jesus Christ. Amen. And so I believe that, yes, you can be saved and not say it happened on January 23rd, 1987. Now, I do believe that there's a lot of people, let's say I had not met that guy, I would still be today, you know, and other things, I would probably still today be thinking I am a Christian when I wasn't, because of that intellectual belief. So I think there are probably a good many folks who can't point to a time or day and are not saved. But I'll tell you this too. There are people who can point to a time or day and are not saved too. Mm-hmm. Just because you've said the prayer, okay, on August 23rd, 1987, and it never was a heart thing, doesn't make you saved. It's, you're saved when you believe in the heart. And that's my thoughts about it.
Yeah. We deal with a lot of folks in the church, and generally if they've been to Canoga,
and they go somewhere between the age of 12 and 16, they got saved. It ain't so. I've never been to Canoga, don't know anything about Canoga. I'm just telling you, it ain't so.